Hey Cafe Crew, I know there's a lot of buzz around Nano Banana right now, but Photoshop actually got two partner models, and the other one is Flux Context Pro. And this actually has a lot to offer, so why don't we jump in right now, and we're going to have a look at how Flux compares to Nano Banana, but also how it differs, and where you might actually find it a better choice. So let's jump in and have a look. With the partner models inside of Photoshop Beta, a lot of attention's gone to Nano Banana, but a second model was also added, and that's Flux Context. And Flux has a great place, just nobody's talking about it, so let's talk about it in this video. So about a year ago, I did a review on CG Dream, and we took a look at Flux then, and one of the things that makes Flux kind of stand out is its realism. But first of all, let's compare some things to Nano Banana and Flux. In order to get access to this, you need the Photoshop Beta. So you're just going to go to the Photoshop. Make sure you choose Check for Updates so you get the latest update. Then click on Home and Apps and you should see Beta. If you don't, just click Home and Apps again, and sometimes it pops up again. And then you can install Photoshop Beta. So the first thing we need to do is make a selection. I'm going to choose Control A or Command A. The nice thing about both Nano Banana and Flux is they're content aware, meaning I can select the entire image and just give it instructions on what I want it to work on or replace. In this situation, we want to get rid of the fence. So to remove the fence, what we do is we go up to the Generative Fill, and then we're in Generative Fill. This is where we can choose the different partner models. So here's Adobe Firefly, which still has its place. Then there's Nano Banana, which is in Gemini 2.5. So I recently just did a video on Gemini Nano Banana. I'll link to it so you can check it out. But what we also want to look at is Flux Context Pro. So here it says conversational editing high res. But this can do similar kind of editing, and it seems to give more lifelike results, whereas Gemini Nano Banana is giving a more beautiful result, so to speak. Let me show you what I mean. We're going to choose the Nano Banana here. We're going to type in the prompt, which is going to be remove fence, and then we're going to choose generate. For the rest of this video, I'm not going to make you watch me do that each time. I'm just going to jump straight to the results so we can edit that down. So this is the result we got with Nano Banana. So if we look at it before and after, yes, it removed it, but notice we can see a loss of resolution on that tree specifically right there, because this is dropping into lower res, so we can see that. And also it tends to just kind of move in the frame a little bit. Sometimes it stretches, sometimes it moves. That's just something I've been noticing. All right, so then we've got the same result here. Now you can see the different logo here, meaning we use Flux Context Pro. So if we look at this before and after, we're also losing resolution, but it's also removing the fence without having to make a selection. Now let's compare it to Nano Banana. If we look at Nano Banana is here and Flux is here. And I can actually see a little bit of a line there from where Flux removed it. So in this situation, it looks like Nano Banana is doing better. And in a lot of situations it is. Let's race through some other examples. In this example here, I select everything and we can see change moped to Harley Davidson motorcycle, and we're using Flux. Here's the result. Very good result. Notice it didn't really change the background or the woman very much. You can see the face is slightly changed, but not really a lot. And it was able to create this motorcycle. All right, let's have a look at Nano Banana. Same thing. Shifted the pixels a little bit, but I think this is a better motorcycle that has been generated. Okay, here's where it starts to get interesting. So let's amp this up a little bit. So we're going to use Gemini first, and notice I made some spelling mistakes and it actually is quite forgiving. Make guitar blue, make hair longer and pink, and add stage lights in the background. And here we go. Now we've got a more exciting scene. This is Nano Banana. Now watch this when we use Flux Context. Look at that. Same prompt, but notice no movement in the guitar size. Notice it's exactly the same guitar. It's changed the color. It's changed the hair. and it's added the lights. But notice it's maintained a lot of the original here. Look at that. So we can see we've got a very realistic looking result, like maybe you photographed it yourself. This one's more pleasant looking, but notice it's changed a lot. Still the same person, but notice some people may say, hey, you know what? This is more pleasant looking, but it's not as realistic. This looks more like a real photograph. Okay, so now we're starting to see where maybe Flux has its place. Let's continue. First of all, we just went to say, hey, you know, why don't we dress this woman as a samurai warrior? So we did this in Flux. Look at that. Interesting. Let's have a look at the Nano Banana version. There's the Nano Banana version. So here's the original Nano Banana. Flux. Notice one of the things it tends to do quite well. If you look at Flux, it's keeping the realism. It's also keeping her hair more accurate. But the other thing is, if you look at the leather, look at the detail that is here in this finely detailed leather. Interesting. Let's try something pretty wild. What we're going to do is we're going to take this fantasy photo and see if we can bring a little bit of reality to it. Is we're going to start with Gemini. And then what I'm doing is remove snow and make summertime. Change clothes and makeup to normal casual style. So then we did this. And this is Nano Banana. And I was kind of like, I probably need to get rid of the wings. So I typed a prompt, remove wings. And it did remove the wings. It gave us an entirely new image. That's okay. We'll come back to another variation of that. So let's have a look and see what happened when we did this in Flux. So here we are in Flux. Notice this. Much more true to the original. Then we wanted to get rid of the wings. We did that. Stay true to the original. It got a little weird around here around the eye. But the funny thing is, this would be the time to do a little retouching inside of Photoshop. All right. So why don't we try it a different way? And this time I'm going to try and put everything into one prompt. So we're going to start with Nano Banana. And this time we just add remove wings. We're going to do everything in one hit. This is the result. Very good. Before, after, same kind of pose. Same woman, not sure. All right, and let's have a look. We're going to do the same thing here with Flux. If we look at the before and after, it's definitely the same person. You can see it's not rendering the face as well. And then when we look at the Nano Banana, it's definitely more pleasant. But it's also more Disney, more kind of fake. So I kind of feel like right now, a lot of stuff, it does look better in Nano Banana. But Flux seems to be doing more realistic, if that kind of makes sense. It's not quite there yet, I don't think. But it's very, very close to you know, kind of doing a real-life version versus a Disney version. Okay, let's have a look at another example. So right now, these are all using very simple, plain English prompts. We're going to move to a more complex prompt in a second, and you'll see something interesting. Okay, so we've got this picture here. It's a stock photo. So I'm going to put a table out in front. On the table is a scale model of the woman on a plexiglass turntable. Next to the turntable is a product box with the model came in. The box is cardboard for clear. Writing on it, model of me behind the woman is a 3D printer, as I remember typing that in. So this was all written by hand, so not an overly fancy prompt. But let's have a look and see what the banana did. This is pretty much what I wanted. So the banana created the shelf out front, created the model, put the box in there, and a 3D printer. Very good. In this case, this is what we got with Flux. Not at all what I was looking for. Let's give it a second chance, and we're going to run it live right now. All right. And once again, it just did its own thing. Not quite understanding what I want to do. So in this kind of situation, Nano Banana is going to work much better. And as you can see, Firefly just completely failed. It's just not there for this kind of thing. All right, let me show you where Flux shines. So what I did is I just created a blank canvas here, and then I created a more articulate prompt. Now, the way I created the prompt is I went into ChatGPT and I told ChatGPT to act like an AI prompt engineer specializing in Flux. But what I've done is I've used it to generate some prompts. So what I said here is make a detailed prompt for Flux, make it a highly detailed sea battle scene from the 1800s. So I had it generate a prompt for me here, which has more kind of detail in it. Now, these different parameters didn't seem to work very well, probably designed for a different version of Flux rather than context. So I wouldn't worry about these too much. The aspect does work, but the steps and guidance didn't really work too well. So don't worry with them. And I put this into Flux. Look at the detail it's picking up here on the ship and on the water and everything. It's beautiful. Very detailed. Put the same thing into Nano Banana. Messed up a little bit on the aspect ratio. We can probably fix that. Let me just drag this out. And this is kind of cool too. It's definitely cool. But if you look at the amount of detail in this and the lighting, this is where Flux is really starting to shine. And if we look at this, this is the prompt. It doesn't need the word prompt in there. It didn't seem to hurt it though. But as you can see, you know, much more complex prompt here. So you can start to prompt this with more detailed prompts and it seems to respond very well. And then we did another one with a majestic knight, full plate armor, blah, 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 blah. And let's have a look at this. And I'd say something like that is what our knight should look like. We did a few variations of it. Definitely very nice. Look at that. And if we have a look at this now, creating this using Flux. Bit more ominous. Look at this. And here we have a knight. So this is the one from Flux. This is the one from Nano Banana. Now I feel the one from Flux is just much more realistic. And if you look at the way the light reflects, the background, the way it's interacting with the lighting, a couple of variations here. Let's go to Nano Banana version. And notice the lighting is not as detailed. And let's create a second variation of this one just to be fair. And if I look at this one, I think this is definitely better than the first one. And we can see it's got some good detail in here, but let's zoom in a little bit. It's got nice detailed background here. It's actually a pretty good version. I definitely think the Flux one, when it comes to these detailed things, is more realistic. Nano Banana is giving a cool one, although this is a really good rendition here, but it's not quite picking up the lighting like Flux is. So it seems to me they both have their place. It seems that Nano Banana is giving more of a smooth, clean result, whereas Flux is able to create more detailed and more realistic, but not always as accurate. So I would say, you know, use each depending on what you're doing, but I would definitely keep your eyes on Flux because I think with a little bit more development, it could be giving Nano Banana a run for its money. So as you can see, in most instances, Nano Banana is still the better option, but when it comes to realism, Flux actually kind of edges out Nano Banana in that sense, but in a little bit more time, when Flux gets a little bit more accurate in its renders and has less artifacts, it's really going to give Nano Banana a run for its money and possibly even surpass it when it comes to realism. Now, when it comes to things like detail, it's definitely there. I'm definitely not saying Flux Context is better than Nano Banana. There's a lot of similarities, but then there's also some differences. And don't forget to check out PhotoshopCafe.com for all these written steps. So I'm curious what you think. Drop a comment underneath and let me know. And by the way, check out my tutorial on Nano Banana right here. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.